little creature is full of anger.
Yeah, because Quill's a prick who only cares about
him. But beneath that, he is unfathomably sad.
Hey!
Now he is scared and angry.
Hey, cut it out! What is this, Quill? What's the bug lady doing to me?
Mantis is an empath, Rocket. She can sense your emotions. She's also the one who made us relive our memories.
That was you? We went halfway across the galaxy, got chased by that psycho Hala for a party trick?
It is my job to guide the Celestial One.
What the hell does that mean?
The Celestial One?
You messed with our minds. Why?
I am Groot.
Please just trust her. For me.
I don't trust people for other people. I trust people for
me. I am Groot?
What do you mean? That totally makes sense.
So how is the bug connected to all this?
Oh, I can explain. Long ago...
Wait. Are you gonna spew some long mumbo-jumbo about where you come from and why I should care?
Yes. Is that a problem?
Remember Thanos? Going on like, now that I got this, I'm gonna roll through the galaxy like a giant turd and blah, blah, blah.
Well, I, for one, wanna hear it. All of it.
Yeah.
And it's time for a nap.
Go ahead, Mantis. Enlighten us.
Of course, Peter Quill. I have communicated only through my feelings for years. It is nice to communicate with my mouth. Eons ago,
this bad.
The Eternity Forge coalesced into existence as a way to balance the life energy of the universe. To create, you must destroy. And to destroy, you must create. But such colossal power cannot be wielded lightly. So I was brought in to ensure that the Forge was only wielded by someone deserving, and to help guide the wielder down the right path. But I waited. And waited. Years went by. Many unworthy tried to use the Forge. Some even tried to force me to help them. The Kree decided that no culture had matured enough to use the Forge with the wisdom required. Eventually, the Forge and I were separated, locked away until a time when civilizations could reach the peak of wisdom and maturity.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
And that is only the beginning.
Well, thanks a lot for that, Pete.
Yeah. Hmm. What an interesting and relevant story. Aren't you glad we heard it all, champ?
Someday, Quill, I'm gonna blast you out an airlock.
I have not yet gotten to the most important part.
Kill me.
There is a legend of the Celestial One. The chosen one who shall arrive from the stars to use the Eternity Forge.
This Celestial One, what are they like?
Advanced intellect, emotionally mature, wise being capable of navigating the dark waters of immense power. Someone who can see beyond his own selfish desires.
I don't believe in magic, okay? It's just a lot of superstitious hocus-pocus.
Yet, that which you do not believe in brought you back to life.
Oh, true.
You must reconcile those two facts, because you are the Celestial One.
True.
Oh, you're so full of crap, lady. If Pete is this Celestial What's-It, then why didn't the stupid Forge work? Sure, it brought him back, but when we tried to use it again on someone else, it didn't do a damn thing.
Your loss. I can feel it has been with you for some time. The Forge is limited right now. It can only restore life to a body that is mostly whole and undeteriorated.
That's kind of true.
Well, that sucks.
Who is sucking what?
No, he means that is unfortunate.
It does not have to suck.
What do we gotta do?
The Celestial One must deliver the Forge to the Sacred Shrine. There you can unlock its true power, or destroy it forever.
And that true power is what?
Returning anyone, from any time period,
back to the realm of the living. Okay, get my mom back.
Lost ones, loved ones, I suppose hated ones, too, if you were so inclined.
You can bring back anyone? Like, anyone at all?
Anyone who ever existed can be brought back, so long as you have the required energy, of course. One life for one life.
So someone still has to die for the thing to work.
Let's finish our drinks and go use this thing.
Yes. Oh,
hell no.
Really? Who are you planning to kill?
Well, you're kind of annoying me right now.
Hala wants to use this forge to raise her army. We have to destroy
it. Not until my family is returned to me.
I'm Groot.
Right? Groot says he's on my side. That's 3-1, Gamora. We win.
That is not true. Groot feels the opposite.
Maybe something got lost in translation. Hey, you try understanding I am Groot all the time.
I can't believe I never thought to ask this question until now, and it's terrifying me. Do you even understand, Groot?
Of course I do. I'm sorry, I just don't want that thing destroyed until we use it. It was a one-time thing.
I am Groot?
Okay, a two-time thing.
So, it is a tie then.
Two for using it.
I am Groot.
I'm gonna take a guess. He said two for destroying it.
Don't you get what this means? We can bring back anyone that we lost.
At a cost.
Wow. Okay, this is, it's a lot to process here.
Yeah,
kinda
exactly.
Heavy on the responsibility,
I don't know.
It's... Let me think on it.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I don't know, bro.
Well, one way or another, this all ends at the shrine. Can you take us there, Mantis?
I have never been, but with your help, I believe I can sense its location. May we have some space to concentrate?
Gladly. If anyone needs me, I'll be emotionally unavailable.
And that's new.
Ha ha ha.
You have extraordinarily soft hands. Like, wow. Was there moisturizer built into that tomb thingy?
There was not.
Really? Huh. Well, I guess it's because,
Please, stop talking.
Okay. Yeah, not talking.
I cannot sense the shrine. There is so much unrest among your crew. Their emotions are overwhelming me. They look to you for guidance. Help them.
Tell me to calm down
because you just had
everything okay here?
Not now. Just give us a minute, please.
Should have listened to all that before.
Gamora, I need to talk to you.
Later.
Drax, how are you doing?
I am hopeful the Forge can bring my family back, if you choose to use it.
Well,
So I must trust you would not take away my chance to reunite with my wife and daughter, even though you did not behave in a trustworthy manner.
Uh-huh.
You used that antenna woman's powers without permission. It was wrong of you to do that. Rocket was clearly angered by what that woman said about his emotions.
Come on, it wasn't that bad. Was it?
Our feelings are our own. They belong to us alone.
I just wanted to get to know everyone better. We're all so secretive. We should open up more.
Secrets should be shared willingly, not stolen.
Whoa. That was, That was really deep, Drax.
Her ability to see into our emotions, it must be difficult. I would not wish to know the pain of others as well as my own. Thank you for checking in on me, Peter. You may leave now.
Hey there, Groot. Oh. Is that a friend of yours?
I am Groot.
I'll tell you this. We're all gonna be okay. No matter what happens with the Forge.
I am Groot.
Hey, bud, what's up?
Well, if it ain't Captain Indecision.
What? Are you...
I don't know what's holding you back from doing the right thing here, Quill. I mean, I can count on one paw how many folks ever get a chance to bring back someone they love.
I am Groot.
And what happens if Hala gets a hold of it, huh? This falls into the wrong hands, the whole galaxy is screwed.
The whole galaxy is already screwed. It's always screwed. You think if we destroy this thing, that'll make a difference? Ah, the only ones you're screwing are your so-called friends.
Rocket.
Damn.
You know
Jackass.
What, Pete? I wish the Forge had never brought you back. Yeah.
I am Groot.
You don't mean that, Rocket.
Now you're telling me what I don't mean. Man, the ego on you. I meant every damn word.
I am Groot.
Have a nice night.
Well, that's one way to clear his emotional unrest.
I am Groot.
Fine. Fine.
The fuck.
Hey, are you okay? What the hell was that?
I tried to say everything I could think of. I thought maybe if I asked her to stick around for a while. Ugh. She won't hear it. Not from me. She'll barely even look at me.
Yeah, that's just who she is now. You need to accept that.
Yeah,
I know.
It's kind of true.
It was stupid to even talk to her. Nebula and I, there's no fixing that. We're better off apart. She can get on with her life, and I can get on with mine.
Yeah, you're right. Get the fuck out of here.
I think you're right. She shouldn't stay with us. Let her go somewhere else. Anywhere else.
As long as it's far from me. I'm done with her.
I gotta go all the way and talk to her now. Ah, stop moving.
Hey, Nebula. Yeah, hey, it's me, Peter Quill, but you know that. You mind if I sit? Cool, yeah, this is really, how's the arm?
Ah!
That's for forcing me to give you the cipher.
And that's Jesus for not Christ. Letting me fight the Kree.
Yeah.
Well, you were pretty awful to us, too.
I have every right to be awful to you. And especially to Gamora. Speaking of my dear sister, bet you got an earful. What'd she say about me? That I'm a waste of space. That I deserve everything I've been through.
You're pissing her off.
She says you're really pissing her off.
Well, the feeling's mutual. I bet she forgot to mention how she ruined our family. How she destroyed my life.
Yeah, well, that's not how it looked to me.
What do you mean?
When we were in the temple, I saw Gamora's memory of your last mission.
Oh, yeah? What did you see?
I saw you stab her and leave her to die.
You have no idea what really happened that day. And neither does Gamora.
Not all of it, at least.
Then show me.
Now, please take my hand.
If this kills me, I'm going to kick your ass.
Oh my god. Oh shit.
Is everything all right? What's going on?
Thanos wants to talk to you.
To me?
Nebula, my favorite daughter.
Father.
Oh, is this the same one?
Your attacks against your sister were swift, precise.
Oh, this is her surface.
You disarmed Gamora easily. I was impressed.
I don't know.
Gamora is a good teacher. I owe all my knowledge to her.
And yet you emerged the victor. You have clearly outgrown her teachings. There is something you must know about Gamora. She has told me that she does not believe you are ready for this mission. That you never will be. Every day, she grows more agitated and bitter as she watches you surpass her. You've seen her lack of respect. She disobeys me time and time again. I no longer trust her. You shouldn't trust her either, Nebula. Gamora has become a risk to our family.
You can always trust me?
You can trust me, Father.
I betrayed her.
I know you will never disappoint me, Nebula. I caution you to be careful with your sister. That is all I ask. If she continues to be a problem, you might take her place. Stand by my side as my greatest warrior and only daughter. Gamora makes herself more useless, more unreliable with each passing day.
I'm fine with that.
It would be an honor, Father.
We shall see how things go on Phalion. This is your moment. Go and prepare. Keep your communications open. I'll be monitoring the situation.
Point now.
Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me!
Tarval was about to kill you, Nebula. I just saved your life. I know you want to impress Thanos, but trust me. He is not worth dying over.
Nebula.
Father.
If you want to gain the honor you desire, kill Gamora. If you don't get rid of her, I will do it myself.
I mean, you already did.
Only I will ensure that your sister suffers greatly.
If there's the options, give me the
option.
I'm about to do it.
The device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me. Now! I'm not asking here.
No, that's not how this works. I don't take orders from you.
Then you leave me no choice.
What are you?
Oh, I did it anyway, sorry.
is it done?
What's going on? What are you making him see?
It wasn't over.
Yeah, oh, man! We were just getting to the part where she, you know.
What?
The part where she kills you?
I was trying to show him what really happened with Tarval, but of course you interrupted us.
This is between you and me.
Like you haven't been telling him your side of the story. He came to me because he was sick of hearing about it from you. She was always pushing against Thanos, testing his limits. What happened was her fault.
Yeah. I practically shoved that knife into my own back. Too bad I had such terrible aim. Some assassin.
Gamora, I wasn't trying to kill you.
Oh yeah? Then what were you doing?
Because it looked exactly like you were trying to kill me.
She was just following orders, Gamora. Thanos made her do it.
He didn't make me do anything. You do what you have to for family.
What a load of crap.
I saved your life.
Admit it. You just wanted to prove you were better than me. By killing
me. If I wanted to kill you, you'd be dead. Thanos was going to kill you himself. There would have been nothing left of you. Do you know? I even checked your pulse. Just to make sure you were still alive. You never got to see that part. The most important part. But I did.
The only thing I know is I feel real sorry for the both of you.
Exactly.
Man.
I'm not...
Talk about family drama.
Well, clearly, this was pointless.
Y'all niggas are fucking crazy.
You know what else is pointless? Trying. With you.
I want you out of my life. For good.
Well, at least we're on the same page about that.
Good.
Good. I can't believe you just said you wanted me out of your life!
You agreed with me!
Guys, stop. Family always works itself out. That's the beauty of having one.
That's kind of true, yeah.
Do you think...
Bloodlines, like that.
Do you think we should maybe... try?
Might as well.
Alright.
We'll be fucking arguing every damn day.
Peter, I can finally sense the shrine.
Okay. Let's go.
Guess this is really happening.
Yeah. Y'all kiss and make up. Y'all fight one more time and split y'all up. Blood on the tracks.